Got another one for you. I'll do this one kind of quick. It's actually just a motherboard. This is the output that I have here. Put a little piece of plastic to help with the glare. Be able to see in just a second. I'll show you. My last video, I told you I had a phase two. Here's phase two, taken all apart. What happened up here is for the real-time clock to work, I figured out I didn't give it enough address space, so I ended up having to do this right here, a little mess, to try to make it have enough address space. It was actually this circuit right here is what I had to add, and it worked. It did work, but it made it ugly, and I already sealed the back, you know, so there's nothing I could do, and it still defeated what I wanted to do in the first place, which was make just a motherboard. So this one is scrap, no good. Wasted a good ZIF socket on it though. That's the only thing that gets me. I'll have to see if I can get that out of there. At least I didn't waste the chips though, my display. So here's the display. Let's get this out of the way. You can see that it's just plugged into, looks like an IDE ribbon coming over to my proto board. Nothing on the proto board. There's one chip over here that I use for decoding, and that's a 139 74 HC 139, to decode my IO for the output for each screen here. That's all I need because I built the motherboard I've been wanting to do. Let's see if I give it a little light, see if it might help it. This is just only what's necessary. I'll bring it a little closer here. We got a processor. This is your low order demultiplexing latch, but it also works as a buffer. Now I used another one over here, but I tied it so it's always on, so it's a buffer for the high order address. And then I used a 74245 bidirectional buffer for the data. And here's my ROM and my RAM, which is a non-volatile 32K static RAM memory chip. I have an inverter up here that the only thing it's being used for is to generate the inverted IOM so that I can, I don't have to do it over here, you know, whenever or any other board I add on, because anything connected to this is going to be an IO device. So I went ahead and generated that signal there. This chip here makes my memory read-write command and makes my IO read-write command, and these two chips are the chip select for RAM or ROM. And I added some DIP switches up here and my reset circuit. This one is running at the 8.064 megahertz, which you know, divided in half, 4.032 megahertz for the clock frequency of the CPU. I did on this right here, number 12, if I turn number 12 on, you can write to here. So what you can do is you can get another one of these non-volatiles, put it over here, make your main monitor program, and flip that switch, and you can now have 64 kilobytes of non-volatile storageable RAM. Let's see. And like I said, I made it where it all just comes right out. You got your power wires, 40-pin connector here, and these are extra pins for some of the other devices I needed. We can see that I used a Express PC board to draw this real quick, so it'll help me know what I have. These will generate, if I hit the DIP switches over here, will generate a trap or one of these interrupts, interrupt request or a hold. I can hit the ready or the ROM write switch, so I can write into it. And then this shows all the pinouts, ground, VCC ground, these are all ground, and then I have my interrupts and my traps, my data pins, address pins all the way down, hold, interrupt, interrupt request, IO write, IO read, IOM, reset out, read write, S1 and S0, your clock out, your ready, your SOD, your SID, your inverted IOM, and your address latch. So I made this, of course, because I couldn't remember every single one of these pins. I'd have to have my sheet, of course. But it seems to be alright. I like this one. Basically all I have to do is make a bus and plug this into it, and then I get the different cards to plug into the bus. I do have some programs, actually a basic in assembly code I was able to find on the internet. So if there's anybody who wants to help me figure out how to get this basic compiler to work with my system, you know, I just need to figure out what ports do I put everything on. You know, I've looked at the software, but it's so it's crazy on that one. But I think it'll be a lot of fun. We'll be able to figure it out. If somebody doesn't know, it'll take me some time, but if we'll get it, we'll get something going. And I think that's probably about it. We just wanted to make a quick one. I wanted to make a quick one real quick, show you how it works. I was pretty happy with myself to get this one going. And this program is using the call function and a timer and all that, so it is using all the RAM. It's jumping all over just to do this. I purposely did that so I could test it, make sure it's all working. And it works pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it. So I appreciate your time, and keep looking for more videos.